Welcome in this video, and in this one I'm going to explain to you what are hashtags and how exactly to use them and to use them correctly. So let's go to the definition first. It says a word or phrase precede means that goes before, by a hash sign. Hash is this little thing, hash sign, used on social media websites and applications, especially Twitter, to identify messages on a specific topic. And let me show you an example of this so that you have also something to look at. A word or phrase preceded by a hash sign. This is the hash sign that precedes the word. And let's say the word is motivation. So word or phrase preceded by a hash sign, used on social media websites like Instagram and applications, especially on Twitter, to identify messages on a specific topic. What are the messages here? It's funny. Okay, let's say, okay, this is a message. Okay, or let's say this is a message. Warriors never quit, they fight till their last breath. So, with this hashtag motivation that we put, we identified a specific message here. Or this, yeah, this message. On a specific topic. Topic means it's a subject. So, this is a specific subject. The subject of motivation. So, yes. Okay, and what you want to do when you post something, you want to use hashtags, but you want to use specific hashtags, not just every hashtag. So let's say we want to go to love. As you can see here, hashtag love, this hashtag has 1.4 billion posts. So if you post something like a photo or a video and you put hashtag love, your post is going to go to between these many posts. So it will be very difficult for another person to find your post with this hashtag. Yes. So the basic idea, if you can see here, this hashtag has many posts, as you can see here, 1.4 billion, and the posts that go to the top have many likes and comments. So in the beginning, it's not recommended that you put, hashtags with so many posts inside them, inside this category, because your post, if you don't have, let's say, 700 likes and 12 comments, it's not gonna be on the top. It's gonna go to the bottom and maybe to the bottom of this 1.4 billion posts. So you don't want to do it. A smart way to do it in the beginning is to use hashtags that don't have so many posts. Like, for example, if you want to put something like love, love quotes would be better if the hashtag is fitting with your post, because love quotes have 12 million posts. And again, 12 million is a kind of a big number for the beginning, but not like 1.4 billion. Loves, that would be better. 6.5 million. So if you put a post and then you put this kind of hashtag, okay, now it's a bit weird here. Yeah, then your specific post is going to compete better with the other posts because there are less posts in that category. So for example, if you have a specific post, or if you're putting out a specific post about someone, let's say, loving himself, or you need to love yourself, or something like that, It's better if you put this quote, this hashtag, that has 31 million. So you get the idea, the general concept. Another example would be fitness. For example, if you have a specific account that promotes fitness, or if you have a business that is about fitness, and you want to put hashtag fitness, if you see here, hashtag fitness has 300 million posts. So it's not the best thing to use, because you compete with so many posts. But if you go a bit below, fitness freaks would be better. Fitness quotes would be much better. Like, the less number of posts in the category, the more likely it is for people to find your post and to like it, comment, then find your account and follow it, etc. And if we go a bit more specific here, you see, let's say here, that person has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hashtags in her post. Instagram actually allows you to put up to 30 hashtags. So, and if you put 30 hashtags, Instagram will not give you the possibility to promote your post, and will drop actually the post in ranking in those hashtags. So Instagram does not like it so much when you have 30 hashtags, because Instagram sees it like spamming, or, you know, something like that. So you don't want to do it. In the beginning, you can actually start with 25 hashtags if you want, but at some point, as you go forward, it's better to see and understand which hashtags work for you better, and use those hashtags, and not all of the other, you know, hashtags, like 30 hashtags or something like that. No, use about 3 to 8 hashtags. This is a good number of hashtags. And also, as a note, we can go to Yannis here, motivator guide. And we can see we can see here that actually Yannis here, he has motivator guide, and he said follow me at motivator guide, and also put a hashtag with his own username. So you can actually do it, and it is recommended also that you start doing it a bit in the beginning, and then afterwards also, because when people come here and actually and find your account, here you can see that your account, or in this case Yannis' account, has turned into hashtags also. So that's very good. You actually want to do it, because then your account will go up in rankings. People may start using your account, your username, to do posts, and then tag you as a hashtag, and then you start branding your account and your name more and more. And also, as an idea, and a smart idea also, it is that you can actually ask other people to post their posts, and then and hashtag your username, so that you start creating something like this in the end. And as a last note, if we go here, this is Hashtagify. This is a website that you type hashtags. Let's say we type motivation, or let's go for something different, random, Let's go for coffee. If you see here, it gives you statistics and numbers on popularity, recent popularity, monthly trend, it went down, weekly trend, it went down also, and full analysis. So it actually is very helpful. You can see statistics and numbers on which hashtags to use, and so that you do your best job doing your posts. And also, there is another video that we speak about Hashtagify as a phone application. And you can actually go to Google Play Store and download Hashtagify. And then you can actually do posts in Instagram. And then Hashtagify has ready hashtags for you. It is very easy to use it. So go and check the video that we speak about that. And yes, this is it, the whole information on hashtags for today. I hope it was helpful, and put it into application, and I will see you in the next one.